Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we're going to talk about how to get an oil analysis for the engine oil in your B58. Now I've talked a little bit about engine oil and how to pick the right one for your car in the past, so feel free to check that video out if you need that for a starting point, but in this one we're focusing on specifically getting an oil analysis done and how the oil analysis looks on my car. So like I explained in my previous video, I've run 0W20 and 5W40, and now I'm actually running 5W30 just to try out different engine oils and see what works best, especially at, you know, the higher power levels and just my driving conditions. I want to make sure that I'm picking the right one. So if you're in the same boat and you're getting ready to do an oil change, I highly recommend getting an oil analysis done. You can even do this between oil changes just to make sure that your engine oil is holding up, or it can tell you that, you know, it's breaking down and it's something that you either need to change more frequently, or it's something that you need to change to, you know, a different oil weight for your specific setup. Now the company that I'll be using is Blackstone. This is their logo, and they do work internationally, but they are located in the US. They're actually in Indiana. So if you're looking for a company to work with, check out their website and they will show you everything that you need to do to get started. They'll send you this container, and this basically has all of the shipping information on it and everything. So all you'll need to do is fill it up, and then you'll drop it off at the post office, and they can actually ship it out for you. Now, if we open this up, we can see what's inside of there. So you have a little plastic bag. Then you also have some additional paperwork that you'll need to fill out. And also this is just, again, to help prevent oil from getting everywhere. And then you have the actual container itself. So this is the container that you're going to fill up. Put your oil in here, and then you put it into this container and actually ship it out. Now, unfortunately on the B58, we don't have a dipstick, but if you did have a dipstick, you could actually extract oil from there and put it into that container. So like I said, you could do that in between oil changes. But because our cars don't have dipsticks, what you're going to need to do is basically drain it from the bottom into a container so that you can ship it out. So I put it into this jar just because I didn't have the kit from Blackstone yet when I did my last oil change. But if you do have the kit, then you can drain it directly into that container. So drain it out. It's only a couple ounces that they actually need. And then you can put your drain plug back in and add some more oil from the top to make sure your level's completely topped off. Now, this specific sample that I pulled from my car is using 5W40. I've used it for about 6,000 miles. About 2,000 miles of that was running full E85 on the stock turbo. And then the other 4,000 was running an ethanol mix or pump gas with my big turbo setup. So I'm going to go ahead and top off that container, and then we'll ship it off to Blackstone and see how it works. I think it should be pretty good because I've seen a lot of good results from other people running 5W40 as well. But again, just for my specific car, driving style, etc., I want to get my own oil analysis done so I know it's the right oil for me or if there's anything I should change. So let's go ahead and send it out and wait for the results to come back. All right, so fast forward 2 weeks, and now we're back in my engine bay, and you can see I have my report back. So I'll put the actual wording down in the description in case it's kind of hard to read on here, but everything came back pretty good. The car is not getting ready to die, which I think we all kind of expected, but it's good just to get your own information. So we kind of went through all the numbers. They're all pretty much in line with a car that typically is at this mileage and running these kind of intervals. So the only thing that stood out was the iron content. Now they say that the iron content is probably high because of the style of driving that I do. Like I said, I pretty much redline my car every day and I just kind of like running through the gears. So because I'm running it hard, that may be a contributing factor to the iron levels. It still doesn't seem like catastrophically bad, but it is higher than what they typically see. Also, something else that was pretty cool, you can see that the fuel is still very low. So even though I was running fully 85 last year, it didn't seem to contaminate the oil that much, and I'm still doing fine with the oil that I have. So now that I'm back on an ethanol mix, I'm less concerned about it, but that was probably one of the main things I was worried about, being that I was running fully 85 and I wasn't sure how much that was contaminating my oil for, you know, the 2,000 to 3,000 miles last year. Overall, this is pretty good. I do see that I put in the submission that I had put 5,000 miles on the car when really it was about 6. So now that they're saying I can try up to 6,000 miles, that would probably indicate about 7 in my case. But I just do an oil change once a year, and since I drive about 6,000 miles a year, that's going to stay pretty consistent. But otherwise, this shows great news. You know, the oil is doing exactly what it's supposed to do. Now that I have 5W30, I'll be submitting another sample next year, and that'll fill in the next column, and I'll be able to monitor over time how the different oils have an effect on how my engine is performing. So that'll also be some good data to look at a year from now. So yeah, I hope this video helps. Again, I highly recommend doing this yourself. Nothing that I or anybody else says can guarantee what will work best for your engine and your driving style and your environment. So just get it checked. It's pretty cheap, pretty quick, and something that you can just do to get additional data to help answer those questions for yourself as far as how often should I change my oil, what oil should I run, etc., etc. So yeah, thanks for watching. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do 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 do.